Today we've been learning about taking the low place so that we will not be put to shame and will be exalted by others and not ourselves. We also learned that in doing good, we should keep an eternal perspective, not seeking applause and reward in this world. We also saw that many do not heed God's invitation to salvation because they are filled with pride. Someone might ask the question, shouldn't I seek to get ahead and do well for myself rather than take the low place in life? In today's lesson, we learn the importance of not honoring ourselves, but rather to humble ourselves by preferring the low place. But the truth is that none of us likes to take the low place. No one wants to be last in the queue or to let everyone go before them. It is in our selfish nature to assert ourselves and push ahead of others. Unfortunately, our tendency to think only of ourselves makes for an unhappy environment to live in. No one seems willing to give, to serve, to let others go first. So the result is pushing, shoving, corruption, stealing, lying, and a host of other sins. Exalting self might be the way the world works, but it is not the way of Christ. If we are to be His followers, then we must learn to be different from the world and take the low place. Jesus went from the highest place in heaven to the lowest place possible upon a cross of shame and suffering. He did all of this for our sakes. He did it so you and I could be exalted to heaven. It is hard to humble ourselves and to let others take first place, but when we do it, then we are acting as Christ would act, and we glorify Him. Also, when we humbly take the low place of servitude as a Christian, then we have the hope of one day being rewarded in heaven. The man who takes the low seat at the wedding feast will be asked to move to a better seat of honor by the host. The Christian who is willing to humble himself and go low shall also one day be exalted with honor when in the presence of Christ. It is a strange paradox that those who humble themselves shall be exalted, but that is what Jesus teaches. When we act that way, the world will think we are quite strange. By faith, we know that one day our sacrifices will be rewarded in heaven. If you worry about what your friends think of you or what your family expects of you, then you will not be able to obey Christ in being a faithful disciple. The world and your family will call you to exalt yourself, to make the best of this world, and take everything you can to be rich and live in luxury. It has a great appeal to most people because they prefer the immediate satisfaction that comes from catering to their pride and wants. It is only by the eyes of faith and looking onward beyond this world that we can give up the treasures of this world in view of the treasures of heaven. Jesus does not call His followers to an easy and exalted life in this world. It is a life of taking the low place. It is a life of bearing a cross, denying self, of choosing Christ over family, friends, and riches. Why would anyone want to follow Christ if it is so costly? It might even cost us our lives if we are bold in preaching the gospel. So why do it? Why pay the price? We could ask the same question about why Jesus went to the cross. Why pay this price? Why do it? The Bible gives us the answer to this question when it says, "For the joy that was set before Him, He endured the cross." Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Jesus looked beyond the cross to the joy of having us in heaven with Him and enjoying His presence for the eternal ages to come. Based on the joy that was to come, He was willing to go low, to take the low place and suffer pain, loss, rejection, sorrow, humiliation, and an agonizing death. He did it all in love for our souls to bring us to heaven. When we ask why we should take the second place, why should we humble ourselves, be willing to suffer and allow others to take the place of honor? The answer is found in our Lord's example, who had His eyes set on the joy that was before Him. If we could only get a glimpse of all that He has in store for us in heaven, all the honors and exaltation, we would be so glad to suffer with him for a short season, so we can enjoy an eternal place in heaven with Jesus. Moses made this choice in his life, when he could have enjoyed the riches and privileges of Egypt, but chose rather to suffer with the Hebrew slaves. The scripture says this about Moses: choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 25.